Recently, there are many people are saying that we need to send the report of Power BI into an attachment as a PDF through an email on a daily scheduled basis. For that, we have one way that using Power BI reports in Power Automate, and we can export that into PDF, and from that, we can send it to an email. This is what we are going to discuss in this video. Hi, I'm Mohammed Adnan, and welcome to my channel, Tech18. In our channel, we discuss a lot about Power BI, Power Automate, Power Apps, SQL, Excel, YouTube, and Alteryx, and much, many more incoming in future. So, visiting first time to this channel, or if you haven't subscribed yet, just click on the subscribe button, and also press the bell icon to get the latest notifications. Now, let's go into the requirement. This is my workspace, and here I have this COVID-19 second view report. Let's have a look at this report. In this report, I have two pages, one is home and table. I want to export only the home page from here into a PDF and send it to the other people on a regular basis. That's the requirement, basically. So for that, this is the report, and I had to go to my flow. You have to click on the create sign here and then schedule flow. I want to schedule it here. COVID-19 second wave, India. So it's every day. I'm going to schedule it at 10 a.m. and create. It's a reoccurrence, and I need to add a new step. Here I need to select the Power BI as a connector, and if I click on that, I have this much of actions. Here I need to select this one, export to a file of Power BI reports, which is in preview right now. And then it will give these much options. First of all, you need to select the workspace. I'm going to select this one, and then the report name. This is the one. And in export option, we have PDF, PowerPoint, and image. So I'm going to select the PDF. Locale is not necessary. If you want to include the hidden pages, yes or no, no. And bookmark name and state. If you want to specific a bookmark you want to export from that, then you can also do that. And if you want to apply any kind of report level filter, you can do that. There are multiple options here, and also the page names. And there are options here which say if you want to export a particular visual, you can also do that. And the bookmark page name and bookmark page state. These are the things for the advanced feature which we am going to cover on future videos. For that, this is enough. And the next step I need to add here is a new one is for the email. So I'm going to select email here and send an email. And here I need to select, give it my name. And in the subject, you can give your email subject, COVID-19 second wave. And in the content also, you can write whatever it is. So auto generated. And in advanced option, and you have like attachment. So if you click here on the right side, this menu, you need to select the file content. And in the attachment file name, you need to give it a name. So I'm going to give COVID-19 India dot PDF. So here you need to mention the dot PDF, then only it's going to export correctly in PDF. Even though it exports into PDF based on these options, but as an email attachment, you have to give a name and dot extension as well. Once it is done, click on save, ready to go, and then click on test. If you set it to automatic, then it will schedule on the schedule refresh time, or as manually, you can click on manually and click on test and run flow. Done. It takes few seconds to a few minutes, depending upon the report what you have. So this is done. So now let's have a look at my email. So I got an email with the subject and with an attachment. We just click on this one. Okay, if we click here, it's 2.3 MB, and I got this PDF with two pages. So this is the one, and this is the one. This is awesome, right? So this is how you can able to export your Power BI report into PDF and send it to an email. But point to note, you had to be in premium capacity as well as you had to buy a Power Automate license for that. If you like this video, just click on the big thumbs up button. If you're new to this channel or if you haven't subscribed yet, just click on the subscribe button and also press the bell icon to get the latest notifications. But make sure you turn on the notification on your devices. If you're not a member of our channel, just hit the join button to know in detail about it. Share it with your friends and colleagues. If you have any queries and feedback, just post it on the comment section below. Thanks for watching. Keep learning. See you in the next video.